Hello, my name is Tapas and I represent a startup called Spaceha. We are a portfolio company of Indian Angel Network since April 2019. We are based in Pune, and Spaceha is a startup in the automobile maintenance industry. As a company, we are a B2B e-commerce company for automobile parts. Our company helps car buyers and service centers and retail stores buy automobile parts at low prices and with fast availability. Our startup works in the automobile industry and especially in the maintenance sector for four-wheeler cars, passenger cars. Before the COVID came, our business was mainly in three cities of Pune, Mumbai and Bangalore. In these cities, our startup provided automobile parts to car service centers, garages, mechanics, and retail stores. When COVID came, COVID had definitely had a very negative impact on our business. Because of the lockdown, all the car service centers and garages had shut down. Especially in these main cities of Pune, Mumbai, and Bangalore, the usage of cars had dramatically gone down because of the lockdown. And there was no maintenance activity, and hence consequently there was no sale and purchase of automobile parts. We had a huge cash flow problem issue also, and the cash flows almost dried up, and we had to struggle a lot to generate demand and sell automobile parts. So how did we cope with the COVID situation? First of all, we changed the business model in a way so that the business generates much more cash from the business operations, and we started out reaching to a different set of customers so that demand could be generated from them. So apart from the traditional customer segment to whom we catered, we started catering to new customer segments as well, and we changed the terms of the trade of our business in such a way that the cash flow generation was higher, the profitability was higher, and the expenses were reduced. As a company, we also geographically expanded. So we added a new revenue stream. We added a new division in our company, which was the franchise store division. And this was catered mainly to the tier 2, tier 3 and tier 4 cities in India. So we partnered with local entrepreneurs in tier 2, tier 3 and tier 4 cities. And because the COVID impact was lesser as compared to the tier 1 cities and metro cities in tier 2, tier 3, 3 or 4 cities, there was demand and business from the rural India market. So this helped us generate demand, and we also changed our business model in such a way that the profitability of the company improved and the cash flows of the company also improved. So we had the learnings that we had in the first COVID wave, we extended those same learnings into second COVID wave, and we came out to be much stronger. So the business impact during the second COVID wave was much less because of the learnings that we had in the first COVID wave. We also, with the franchise model that we started and our penetration in tier 2, tier 3 and tier 4 cities, with this we were able to spread scale the business geographically from just 3 cities in which we were earlier present before COVID to almost 50 cities to which we are present now. So we have customers in 50 cities spread across India, covering more than 14 states. So we were able to scale our business during the COVID wave due to change in our business model, and maintain our revenues and improve the profitability and improve the cash flows as well. Right. So surprisingly, the business has become actually much stronger and healthier after this, during the second and after the second COVID wave. And as a company, we are EBITDA profitable as well as cash flow positive because of the changes that we were forced to do during the first wave of COVID and the constant improvement and innovation in the business model of our company. So as a company, we are much stronger than what we were pre-COVID, not only from the business perspective, but also from the employee efficiency point of view. We focused a lot on the efficiency of the employees, on improving the internal processes and automating things. And hence, we were also able to improve the efficiency with the same set of employees. We are able to generate much higher revenues, higher profitability, and higher tasks per employee. This also taught us the importance of a healthy business model, a scalable business model that can grow without too much of money to be invested into that, and the importance of profitability and cash flow positiveness. Indian Angel Network helped us a lot during the COVID period. So as our prime and lead investors, during first COVID wave, they actually extended more funds to our company, which helped us with time so that we could change the direction of the company and grow further and adopt to the new change. Apart from that, we received great support from our board members who are members of Indian Angel Network, and they guided us and showed us the right path during these challenging times. There were also a lot of knowledge sessions which were conducted by Indian Angel Network, which helped us get a grasp of the challenges which were prevailing at that time and how other startups are solving those problems. They also helped us with the connects and network access so that we could expand our business, improve the efficiency of the operations, and connect to new customers, new vendors, as well as new investors as well. Apart from that, they also helped us keep us motivated because of the constant interaction with the members and the office bearers of Indian Angel Network. So that not just the founders, but the entire team of Spare Sub was motivated to keep on going forward. Last, my message to my fellow startup founders is that tough times don't last, but tough people do. So we just have to keep at it, and we should surround ourselves with people who keep us motivated, because sometimes during the challenging times, it is these friends, family members, investors, board members, and well-wishers and our mentors who actually keep us motivated, who ensure that we are working with the correct mindset, and we overcome this situation. So there will always be challenges. COVID was one challenge, but I've seen some of the best ideas and best businesses grow during this COVID wave. And COVID was just one challenge. Challenges will keep on coming in future as well. It might not be in the form of COVID, but it could be in the form of any other economic or security challenge or other challenges which businesses face.